I'd like to introduce to you all the topic for our panel discussion, Drive 3G or Go Beyond? Is there a unique solution for all markets?
To channelize and moderate the discussion, we have with us our moderator, Mr. Babu Rajan, Executive Editor, Voice and Data. I request, sir, to kindly take his seat on the stage. Mr. Babu Rajan is the executive editor of Voice and Data, which is the leading telecom magazine in India and is circulated in the SAARC region as well. Sir has been working with Voice and Data for the last 3 years and has also moderated various telecom events in India and abroad. As a journalist, he has covered telecom industry for the past 14 years and is passionate about 3G. We welcome you, sir, to Communique 09. Now, we invite our distinguished panel members on the stage.
Mr. Manoj Dawane, Chief Executive Officer, Moj Limited.
Mr. Amit Goyal, founder, Knowledge Faber.
Mr. Kundan Das, director, Solutions Marketing, Starent Networks.
Mr. Roger Zhao Ping, Senior Telecom Expert and Vice President, China Telecom.
Mr. Shyam Kaushal, Regional Director, WiMAX Forum.
Mr. Abdul Khan, Head Marketing, Tata Docomo, Tata Teleservices, Maharashtra Limited.
Mr. Vijay Jain, Chief Executive Officer and Founder, Astute Systems Technology.
On the behalf of Symbiosis Institute of Telecom Management, we welcome.
The first question is to Mr. Kundan Das. Are we ready for the 3G revolution in India? Is the right time to introduce 3G? Is the right time to invest in 3G? Is the right time to use 3G as a technology?
If you look at 3G, actually it has evolved in multiple technology in last couple of years. Like when we're talking of 3G, it started up with WCDMA. So WCDMA came in picture in 2000, but between 2000 to 2006, I think it was WCDMA. Then the WCDMA operators, they migrated to HSPA, and now right now it is HSPA Plus. So that means 3G itself, as a technology definition or technology change, it has gone through a two-phase change. So far, WCDMA or 3GPP standardization is concerned. On the another standardization, which is again widely used, that is 3GPP 2, it started up with 1X, then RAV 0, then RAV A. at this point in time. And globally, Rayway is used by almost all the major CDMA carrier to name like Verizon, Sprint, KDDI, all are using it. HSPA is again used by most of the leading 3G operators like Vodafone, Docomo, all of these, AT&T. Now, there is one more addition to the technology list is 16E WiMAX. Now, that is something which started up as an active investment invested by Sprint Clearware, followed by KDDI in the year 2007-2008. Now, if you look at this point in time, we ask a lot of questions that whether India got late in investing in 3G. Actually, if you analyze the technology mapping, it is not late. We are right now investing on the technology. Fortunately, the technology is mature. So in comparison to HSPA, we are just 1 year behind. And probably we can take that 1 year as a learning curve or maturity of the ecosystem in HSPA. In comparison to Rayway, we are maybe 2 years, lagging. And we can take again that, fortunately, because of Rayway, we are finding the Rayway data cards available at 3,000 price point in India, which is supplied by, Tata, Reliance, and BSNL, if I'm not wrong. So what I can say is that, the introduction of the technology, so far the timing is concerned, we are actually not late. Now, the second question is that LTE or 4G technology, whether we are ready to go for 4G.
We'll come back to the LTE part, we'll discuss.
We can come back later. So I can say that we are very much at the right timing, I can say. We are not at all late. If we would have invested in WCDMA, our operator would have again gone for a CapEx, change when they would have gone for investing in HSPA Plus. So I think it's very much in the right time.
We think about seconds, thanks to Docomo. They're actually revolutionizing the pricing pattern, the business dynamics of the wireless operators. What is your experience? What, if you get the spectrum, what will be your main offering for the consumer?
I think it's really premature because we are working out, like I'm sure many operators, in terms of business plans, in terms of what we will offer, when we will offer, where we will offer. But having said that, I think the first point I'd like to make really is Docomo itself is a pioneer in this area, in 3G really. And it's one of those few operators which has, I think, a 3,500 member research and development center. That's one input which I think was going to be very, very important for us. But having said that, I'm not talking on a sales story for Tata Docomo or Docomo here. The point out here is that I'm sure you guys are into telecom and you're deluged with acronyms, but the point which we need to see is really what is in it for the customer. What typically in India there would be and there will continue to be parallel existence of various technologies. It's not that there's going to be a wholesale migration from 2G to 3G, 3G to 4G or what have you. There are different areas out here as companies invest, and what we will be looking at is there's a floor price of 3,500 odd crores for an incumbent to invest out here. And what business plan and how far and how fast is he going to get his revenue back? I think that's really the challenge. And whom are we going to talk to? And the classic Indian dilemma is at, obviously, great technology, but at what price? Whether it's handset, whether it's services, at what price point? So affordability and accessibility, I think it's a truism, but that's going to be very important here.
Maybe for the first time in the history of India, we are getting a chance to compare with China, at least in terms of the duration of the launch of 3G services. What are the learnings for you in China?
Thank you. In China, we have just issued a 3G license for several years. I'm very pleased to share my understanding about 3G here. For me, 3G is a story. I'm very lucky to get involved in this story. And the reason why China government issued a 3G license, the critical reason is the financial crisis. I think at first, 3G story is a 3G economy. The second, I think the most important application for 3G technology is the mobile internet. Mobile internet drive the 3G value chain, drive the 3G development. But mobile internet is not